Hi, my name is Ruben Alves. I am from Robot Ignite Academy, and today you are going to see what is the Rose package path variable and how it works. For that, you are going to use this platform, which is the best one if you wanted to learn Rose really fast. Let me start here an intermediate course today, Rose Navigation in 5 days, so we can see this variable in practice. So let's wait until the system loads. And okay, here we have it. Okay. Let's see. If you check here, environment grep ROS, we have here many ROS variables, and one of them is ROS package path. If you look at this variable, we have here a value for it, but we don't know what it really means. ROS package path, what it does is this variable is used by ROS in order to find the packages. If you check here, for example, let's see the instructions about this ROS navigation course. We have in here a command, which is this one. Okay, I'm not going to run it. If you see ROS launch turtleboard teleop and keyboard teleop, this ROS launch command, in order to find the turtlebot package, it is going to look for this ROS package path variable. Let's try to enter in this package turtlebot teleop. If you check in here, we are on the simulations public workspace. And if you look also on the ROS package path, this workspace should be on that variable. Let's try to find here ROS package path, and here we have catkin workspace, and here we have simulation workspace. You see, this package was found because it was defined in this ROS variable. If you try to unset this variable, for example, ROS package path, let's unset. So now if you try to see this variable again, we see we have many ROS variables, but we don't have the ROS package path anymore. Now let's try to enter the same package, which is command ROS turtlebot teleop, and you see ROS was not able to find our package just because we don't have this variable. If you source our catkin workspace again, which is the catkin devel setup bash, now we should have this variable, as we can see here. Now we have this variable again. Now if you try to enter our package once again, you see now it works. It is very important. This variable is what ROS uses in order to find a package. Let's suppose I went on the temp folder and I want to create a package here. Okay, nobody's going to create, but let's say I want to create just to explain the ROS variable in a better way. So let's create a package which is okay, tutorial package. Okay, here we have a package, as we can see here, but if you try to enter this package with ROS CD tutorial package, ROS is not going to find this because this path, the temp folder, is not on the ROS package path, as you can see here. But if you add this variable, we can do this with export ROS package path. We put the temp folder and the path separator is this okay symbol, and we define the variable again, ROS package path. We assign let's check here the variable. Now we have the temp folder here. Now ROS should be able to find this package. Let's run this command again, ROS package path, and here we have, you see, we are in the temp folder on a package defined on the temp folder just because it is on the ROS package path. So this is the video for today, guys. I hope you enjoy. If you like it, please give us a thumbs up, and you can also subscribe to our channel and press the bell for a new video every single day. Thanks for watching.